I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous faults, therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant graciously to your church, O merciful God, that gathered by the Holy Spirit, she may be devoted to you with all her heart and united in purity of intent. Make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, desiring to know the real reason why the Jews accused Paul, the tribune unbound him and commanded the chief priest and all the council to meet. And he brought Paul down and set him before them. But when Paul perceived that one part were Sadducees and the other Pharisees, he cried out in the council, "Brethren, I am a Pharisee, a son of Pharisees. With respect to the hope and the resurrection of the dead, I am on trial." And when he had said it, a dissension arose between the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and the assembly was divided. For the Sadducees say that there is no resurrection, nor angel, nor spirit, but the Pharisees acknowledged them all. Then a great clamor arose, and some of the scribes of the Pharisees' party stood up and attended. "We find nothing wrong in this man. What if a spirit or an angel spoke to him?" And when the dissension became violent, the tribune, afraid that all would be torn in pieces by them, commanded the soldiers to go down and take him by force from among them and bring him into the barracks. The following night, the Lord stood by him and said, "Take courage, for as you have testified about me at Jerusalem, so you must bear witness also at Rome." The word of the Lord. Our response to the psalm is, "Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge."
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I said to the Lord, "You are my Lord. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. You yourself who secure my Lord."
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord before me always. With him at my right hand, I shall not be moved.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad. Even my flesh shall rest in hope. For you will not abandon my soul to hell, nor let your Holy One
some old translation, it says, I will give you a mouth which your adversaries, which your enemies will not be able to contradict or resist. When St. Paul spoke in the presence of the chief priests and all the others who were gathered, he spoke wisdom and he put all his enemies to confusion. That wisdom that came from the mouth of St. Paul is not a wisdom that is acquired. It is not something that is gotten through books or through study or even through experience. No. It is a wisdom that comes from God. It is divinely infused. The first gift of the Holy Spirit, usually mentioned, whether in the scriptures or whether in the tradition of the church, is wisdom. That wisdom is the one that our Lord Jesus was speaking about when he says that, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for hiding these things from the wise and the learned of the world and giving them to us, to men, children. That wisdom cannot be acquired, rather, it's a wisdom that is given. That's why St. James says, St. James chapter 1 verse 5, that if you lack wisdom, ask God for it. Have you asked for the wisdom that you need for life? Or do you even know that you need to ask for it? Have you implored God for that divinely infused wisdom that can only come from him? St. Stephen also had it. He was given an utterance. Was given a wisdom. People came from near and far, from the old world that existed then, to debate with Stephen, but they could not get the better of him. Not because he had studied, not because he knew about Jesus, but because there was divinely infused wisdom. Our Lord Jesus also had it. Because you remember at his temptation, the adversary with the capital A, the devil himself came and tempted Jesus, but because of that divine infused wisdom, he had the gift of utterance. He knew what to say at a specific moment, just as St. Paul did. He knew exactly what to say in order to confuse the situation. So as we expect the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, let us also pray for the gift of utterance. Let us pray for that wisdom which comes only from God. Remember that it is the fear of the Lord that is the beginning of wisdom. That is, anyone who wants to acquire this wisdom must first and foremost do what? He must fear the Lord. That is, from then, put yourself in a proper position to receive this wisdom. Pray for the wisdom of God in our lives, in our families, in the work of our hands. We pray for that wisdom of the Holy Spirit, especially in this difficult and trying moment in which we all find ourselves in the world. But most of all, we pray for this wisdom to be divinely infused in our souls so that we can always choose God in every single situation of our lives. May he bless his word in our hearts this morning through Christ our Lord.
Amen. 57, hymn number 57.
Out of the Lord, you
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in the heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
253, hymn number 253.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you